Welcome back to Latest TV News. Coming up, we'll have your weather forecast where we are. But first, we welcome... Put your clothes on, do you mind? We welcome Duncan Blinkhorn of the Naked Bike Ride. Are you okay? How are you? Nice to see you.
Hello, Mike. Yeah, good, thanks.
I can't believe a year has gone already.
I know, right? Yeah, it's the only... I finished clearing up from one and it's already to start planning the next. But anyway, we're just about ready to go.
Is that what does happen? Do you sort of start organising the next one almost immediately?
It feels like that. We've already got the date for next year up and the poster half designed. So yes, it's endless.
Have you an idea how many people will be taking part this year?
Well, we had about 800 last year. We're expecting, judging by the Facebook response, a similar number. But
really?
It's usually just a bit short of 1,000, yeah.
Yeah, which is not bad, is it?
No, it's a lot of people. We are the second biggest ride in the UK. There's about 15 rides in the UK, so after London, which is the day before, so we're a bit short of the London.
The big question, of course, yeah. I guess everyone says to you, is why? Is it exhibitionism or what?
Well, the roots of the ride go right back to 2003, 2004, the Gulf War, the war with Iraq, a war very much for oil, and many people did naked protests at the time. To draw attention to, well, to oppose the war and using their nudity to emphasise their humanity, really, and a vulnerability to missile attacks. That was taken up by folks in Vancouver, where a lot of that stuff went on, to put people on bikes and oppose a war for oil. Making the point that we need to reduce our dependence on oil because that is leading to resource wars, conflicts. Also, of course, it's adding to climate change, air pollution. So a lot of the problems that we are dealing with in the world are down to that overdependency on oil. And so the bike ride has those roots. It's very much an environmental protest, but it's fun. It's about celebrating cycling, but also being body positive celebrating body power. There's a lot of talk about wind power and solar power, renewable energy, but actually we all have power in ourselves to whether we're walking or running or cycling, to power our way around. So we're drawing attention to those sorts of issues, but doing it in a fun...
This is the 10th anniversary.
Right? So we're celebrating that, 10th anniversary.
10th anniversary
this year.
To start.
Absolutely.
Of course, over the last few weeks, you've obviously seen the publicity to the poster that was up at Brighton
Station. Yes, my goodness.
Well, how did you feel when you heard about that?
I thought it was great to see the picture. I'm not in that photo, but Nick, who started the ride in Brighton, Nick Sayers, who's a local artist, and the poster was about celebrating him, really, as a local artist. But obviously, he's associated with the Naked Bike Ride because he brought it to Brighton and he's still involved with organising it. So, but yes, it was a bit of a shame to take it down, but it got us a bit in the press, didn't it? And it's now hanging at Marwood's coffee shop down in the lanes.
So it's all happening in Marwood's at the moment, I tell you. good place to
what
be.
What else is happening there then?
So what about the criticism you do get? You know, people say that this is not the thing to be putting on the streets of Brighton. You shouldn't be. I mean, your route is enormous. I mean, you start...
Yeah, it's
at
about
level.
9 miles, a bit short of 9 miles. We start at the level, down to the pier, along the seafront, up and then down Western Road. We go around the lanes. We stop at Olsteen for a bit.
Do families, do children want to see this?
Well, to be honest, we get a great response from the public everywhere we go. We get cheers and waves and people get their cell phones out and take pics. So there's very little opposition to it. It doesn't upset many people at all.
No,
quite the contrary. I think it brings a great, puts a lot of smiles on people's faces. And it's a lovely thing to participate in. There's something about taking a kit off and getting on a bike and all cycling together that creates a very strong, immediate sense of community and trust. And that's a great thing. We have music along the way, so it's entertaining for us, but also for people we go past. So I think we add to the colour of the city. We don't want to take ourselves too seriously. And I think that's part of the point of the ride, really, is I think it's very easy to be a bit overly earnest, whether it's cycling or environmentalism and things. You know, we're trying to make low-impact living and cycling fun. And OK, taking a kid off, that might upset a few people. But it's all done in the best possible taste. It really is. And, you know, there's a lot of body painting. And to be honest, we're so fleeting that, if you cast your eyes away, if you don't want to see that sort of thing, you'll miss it anyway.
Yeah. I mean, yes. I have noticed that when there's been children and families watching at the side, they've just been laughing.
Absolutely.
No one yes. been saying, oh, no, you can't look at that, or, you know, cast your eyes away.
Absolutely.
They have been standing there and they've been laughing.
Yeah, and we do, you know, we've always said, you know, we try and run it as a family-friendly event. We welcome families to come along. If kids are on the ride, it's fine. You know, that's a very small uptake on that. But, if, you know, at the end of the day, it's about being more comfortable with your own bodies and not making a big deal of that. And we welcome, you know, the more diversity of bodies that there are, the better for it, to be honest. So it's great to have older people, younger people, you know, bigger people.
Do the riders take offence that people take photographs of them at the time?
No, people expect to be photographed.
Do you warn them that this is going to happen?
Yeah. I mean, I think that's accepted. We do have an issue with some photographers because we do expect and ask photographers to be respectful and if they're taking close-ups to ask permission. And not all the photographers do that come along, and we try and keep those at a distance. And for that reason, we put up a big protected area, a big fence basically, so that any participants feel safe from that sort of intrusive photography. So we don't welcome that sort of photography at all. But of course, we expect it to be photographed, but with respect and consent. And people take selfies and all the rest of it as well, so it's all over the place.
Actually, the police get very involved in this, don't they? They seem very supportive.
The police, we've got a very good relationship with the police on it. We have ever since we started, actually. And you know, they see the public reaction is very positive.
They're laughing as well.
They are. You know, we take the safety of the ride really seriously, and they support us in that. Everyone wants it to be a safe ride.
Have you been waiting for some naked policemen to join you?
Well, one of these days, you never know. A few years ago, I heard some of them did ask if they could have permission to at least wear shorts and short sleeves, but they were turned down on that because they have to wear stab vests and wear full kit, apparently. But it is, I do feel for them a bit because most of the police are on bikes as well, which is great. You know, they do work up a bit of heat.
Was there any problems last year? Did I hear rumour there was a couple of arrests or something? Well, you haven't heard about that.
No, there was an issue, that's right. I think as we were going through the lanes, there was a member of the public that put their hand out to a woman that was cycling on, and basically it was a case of assault, and she pursued an official complaint and had witnesses to that. Very unusual for that to happen.
Well, the first time in 10 years.
That I'm aware of, absolutely. But, you know, we have lots of volunteer stewards on the ride. We do take that sort of thing seriously, and there were stewards around her to support her and to deal with that. And likewise with first aid, we have had the odd fall. I think there was one of those last year.
It was in the lanes, I think, last year, past the Theatre Royal. There was a bit of a pile up there, yeah.
We always have a first aider at the back to attend to that as well.
How did you get involved in this?
Well, I'm a cycle campaigner, so that's why I do it, and an environmentalist. So it makes perfect sense to me. And I went on the first one in Brighton. It was great fun, and I could see the positive reaction it got. So I thought, well, I'll get involved with helping out the following years.
I had great pleasure, by the way, and I think you know this story, when Mary Mayers was in charge of the council, she tried to stop the ride.
She did, indeed, yes.
You kindly allowed me to take photographs at the time.
Right.
And I got a photograph of a man from behind, totally naked, and on the back of on his back it says, Mary Mayers can kiss my, with an arrow down to a certain part of his anatomy. So I actually blew this up and handed it to Mary, and she's had it on her desk for ages. But the whole thing is in humour, isn't it, really?
It is. There's a lot of humour in it. A lot of the body painting, there's a lot of cheekiness in the whole thing.
But how can people take it seriously? Because you are trying to get a serious message across.
There is a serious message about the vulnerability of being on a bike. Far too many people in this country and around the world are killed or seriously injured as a result of accidents. We want to be more visible. So it's, can you see us now, is what some people write on their chests and backs. We want cyclists to be more visible. We want to see cycling facilities in the country and conditions improved so that it's less dangerous for cycling. Understandably, some people are fearful to get on a bike. I think Brighton's getting safer and safer.
Brighton is very supportive of bikes anyway.
Absolutely. I think we've come a long way in 10 years. A lot of people refuse to cycle because they feel it's not safe for them, and I understand that. So those are one of the issues that we're dealing with. In a way, we're taking that idea of vulnerability to an extreme by making ourselves naked. But I think the interesting thing about that is when you are cycling with a whole bunch of people, and the stats in London show that now that huge numbers of people are cycling there, the level of accidents actually reduces. So there is a safety in numbers situation where the more people are out on their bikes, the more visible you are, and the less likely you are to be in an accident.
But a lot of people have the message about oil. That seems to be even more than the cycle.
Yes, well, that's an important message, isn't it? Yeah. I mean, break free from fossil fuels is one of our slogans. And I think if we can get that idea in people's head that actually that we're sort of enslaved in a way to this dependency on oil and coal, we need to liberate ourselves from that. And getting on a bike is one way of doing that. You know, you can get around the city faster than any other form of transport. I appreciate it doesn't work for everyone, but most people it can. A city like Copenhagen, half of journeys are by bike. I don't see there's any reason we couldn't do that in Brighton. That's a realistic ambition. And in doing that, we reduce our dependency on oil.
I hope it goes well for you. Let's hope the weather stays good for you as
Excellent.
Well. Unfortunately, we haven't got the weather forecast. We've run out of time.
Thank you
so much indeed.
Okay.
It's been a pleasure to meet you again. I'll see you on Sunday.
Excellent.
Well
All
done.
Right.
Thank you for the 10th anniversary of the bike ride through the streets of Brighton. Don't miss it. It is fun. It really is. Thanks for your company today. See you again 6 o'clock. Bye for now.